Ricky Martin is one of the biggest Latin artists of all time and is known for his high-energy brand of pop. While he rose to fame as a teen in the boy band Menudo, he went on to not only be an actor but further become a global star for his solo music career. His 1999 English language self-titled album really skyrocketed Ricky to fame, along with releasing the World Cup theme song a year prior, La Copa De La Vida, or The Cup of Life. He's remained a star and released a number of platinum albums, while he's also very involved in philanthropy, mainly LGBT rights and fighting against human trafficking, even founding the Ricky Martin Foundation in 2004. Despite his success, before the late 90s, he was Livin la Vida Loca everywhere but the USA and Britain, and had a long journey to becoming such a big star. But if you want to know all about Ricky Martin's story and rise to fame, then stay tuned, because we'll get into all of that and more here for you on Famous Life. Enrique Martin Morales was born December 24, 1971 in San Juan, Puerto Rico, to mother Doña Nereida Morales, who's a former accountant, and father Enrique Martin Negroni, a former psychologist who once worked as a regional supervisor for a Puerto Rican mental health agency. Now, of course, he's known as Ricky Martin. And Ricky's parents divorced when he was only 2 years old, which meant he spent his childhood shuttling between his mother's home, his father's house in the middle-class suburb of University Gardens in San Juan, and even his grandmother's house, which was nearby. But Ricky had the freedom to spend time where he wanted. He said in an interview he never had to make choices about who he loved more and that he was always happy. Ricky has two older half-brothers from his mom, Fernando and Angel, as well as two younger half-brothers, Eric and Daniel, and a younger half-sister, Vanessa, on his dad's side. Ricky was raised as a Roman Catholic and served as an altar boy. He started singing when he was 6 years old, using wooden spoons as pretend microphones, and often sang songs by the Puerto Rican boy band Menudo, as well as English rock groups like Journey, Led Zeppelin, and REO Speedwagon. His mom's side of the family was musically inclined, and his maternal grandfather actually inspired a young Ricky as he was a poet. Reflecting on time with his family as a kid, Ricky explained, "Every time I find myself in front of an audience, be it 20 people or 100,000, once again I feel the energy that consumed me back at the family gatherings of my youth." Ricky attended a bilingual Catholic grade school in University Gardens from fourth grade called Colegio Sagrado Corazon, and when he was 9, he began appearing in TV commercials. These included commercials for products like soft drinks, toothpaste, and fast food restaurants, most notably for Orange Crush and Burger King, and in a year and a half, Ricky had starred in 11 commercials. Thanks to these commercials, Ricky had gained a bit of fame in his home country and then auditioned to be a member of Menudo, which was formed in Puerto Rico in 1977. The boy band was known for their members usually being replaced when they turned 16 in order to keep the group full of fresh-faced stars. Well, during auditions, the executives enjoyed Ricky's dancing and singing, but thought he was too short. However, he was persistent, which impressed them, and by audition number 3, Ricky became a member of the band at only 12 years old. A month later, Ricky made his debut performance with Menudo, during which he disobeyed the choreography by walking around the stage. When it was planned, he would stay still, which got him in trouble with the manager, Ricky confessed. "That mistake was such a big deal from that moment on. Never again did I move when I wasn't supposed to move. That was the discipline of Menudo. You either did things the way you were told or you were not part of the group." Ricky enjoyed performing with Menudo, but thought the strict management and busy schedule was simply exhausting. He was a key member of the group and a fan favorite, and the band released 11 albums during his time with them. He also developed his initial interest in philanthropy when the group became UNICEF ambassadors, which inspired him to continue working with charities later in his life. However, Ricky's time with the revolving door boy band also caused a rift between him and his family. During short tour breaks, Ricky's father wanted his son to choose between his parents. Ricky seemed to choose his mother, although after a stint as a US soap stud, which we'll get into in a moment, he reconciled with his father, saying, "I hated the estrangement and couldn't live with it anymore." While finally Ricky left the band in 1989 at age 17, despite staying a few extra months after his quote-unquote age-mandated retirement came around for Menudo. He further graduated from high school right after turning 18. He moved to New York City to celebrate his financial independence. Considering he was a minor during his time with the band, Ricky wasn't allowed access to his own bank accounts. Ricky was accepted to New York University's Tisch School of the Arts in 1990, but before it began, he was invited to Mexico City with his friend, where he attended a musical comedy play and asked to stay and replace one of the actors in the show, which he accepted. He then dropped out of university to perform in the play, which is where a producer took notice of Ricky's acting and offered him a role in a Mexican telenovela show. A film based on the series was also produced in 1992, which Ricky also starred in. After his acting was noticed, the Sony Discos executive offered him his first solo music recording contract, and an eager Ricky signed on without reading conditions, signing a deal where he would only be paid 1 cent for each album sold. Despite viewing the contract as unfair, Martin referred to this record as the start of something phenomenal for him. His debut album was a hit on the Latin pop charts and sold over 500,000 copies worldwide. Ricky also embarked on a successful Latin American tour, which broke box office records. Ricky continued to make music and albums that were great successes in Latin America. In 1994, his agent encouraged him to move to Los Angeles to act in an American sitcom called Getting By. And despite the show being canceled after 2 seasons, Martin was given the role of Miguel Morez on the hit soap opera General Hospital. Ricky played the role for 2 years and gained huge popularity and stardom through it. While Martin was actively pursuing his acting career, he was also recording and releasing albums and making concert appearances, and in 1995, he refocused on his music. His third album spawned many hits, including Maria, which was sold over 5 million copies worldwide. His next album, which was released in 1998, featured the hit single La Copa De La Vida, or The Cup of Life in English, which Ricky performed at the 1998 World Cup soccer tournament in France as part of a showcase broadcast to 2 billion people globally. That year, it was confirmed Ricky was working on his first English language album titled Ricky Martin, which was released in May 1999. The album debuted at the top of the charts and had the biggest sales in a week by any album that year, also making Ricky the first male Latin act in history to debut at number 1 on the US Billboard 200 chart. To add to the success of his debut English album and single, Martin was nominated in 4 categories at the Grammys. The album's lead single, Livin la Vida Loca, topped the charts in over 20 countries and became one of the best-selling singles of all time. In November 2000, Martin released the much-anticipated follow-up album called Sound Loaded. Its hit single, She Bangs, earned Martin yet another Grammy nomination for Best Male Pop Vocal Performance. After this, Ricky continued making music both in Spanish and English. His greatest Spanish language hits were featured on La Historia in 2001. This was followed 2 years later by Almas de Silencio, which contained new material sung in Spanish. The album Life in 2005 was his first English language album since 2000. The album did quite well, reaching the top 10 of Billboard's charts, but Ricky has yet to recapture the same level of pop success he achieved with his former albums. In 2012, Ricky appeared on the musical series Glee and appeared in Broadway that April for the musical revival of Evita, playing the role of Che. Martin also starred in the FX series The Assassination of Gianni Versace, American Crime Story, which premiered in 2018. Ricky played Versace's longtime partner Antonio D'Amico, who was there the day Versace was murdered. As a gay man, Ricky also actively supports LGBT rights worldwide since coming out in 2010. He came out publicly with a message on his website stating, "I am proud to say that I am a fortunate homosexual man. I'm very blessed to be who I am." Even before coming out, he was noted by the mainstream media for being popular among gay men, and these days, he's considered to be a gay icon. He also explained later on, "Sexuality is one complicated thing. It's not black and white. It's filled with colors. When I was dating women, I was in love with women. It felt right. It felt beautiful. There was love, passion. I do not regret anything. Any of the relationships I lived, they taught me a lot, both men and women." He also told Fama, "I know that I like both men and women. I'm against sexual labels. We are simply human beings with emotional and sexual needs. I like to enjoy sex in total freedom, so I'm open to having sex with a woman if I feel desire. Before coming out in 2008, Ricky became a father to twin boys Matteo and Valentino, born via surrogacy. These days, Ricky is married to Syrian-Swedish painter Johan Josef since 2017, and in 2018, the couple announced that they have welcomed their first daughter together named Lucia, and not even a year later, Ricky shared a photo of himself, Josef, and their newborn son named Ren. Aside from his work with LGBT rights, Ricky's involvement in activism also focuses on fighting against human trafficking. In 2004, he founded the Ricky Martin Foundation, a nonprofit, non-governmental organization that focuses on denouncing human trafficking and educating about the crime's existence. Aside from possibly welcoming even more children with his husband in the future, Ricky Martin has also embarked on a tour alongside Enrique Iglesias, and I guess we'll just have to wait and see what else he'll be up to. Thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to Famous Life and leave a comment for who you'd like us to feature next.